Today on Grumble and Glorify, we're going to do something a little bit differently. Instead of reviewing a film or a TV show, we're going to talk about them. Specifically, what happens to older TV shows, the obscure ones that aren't really on channels like TV Land or The Hub. Now, I'm sort of on a quest to find this out, since there are many shows from my childhood that I would love to see again, or catch some episodes that I may have missed. Here's what I've been able to gather so far. If you're lucky enough to have had a VCR ready with a blank tape inside during the 80s and 90s, you may be able to catch a full episode of your favorite TV show. If you're really dedicated, you can archive the whole series and release it on the web for other people's enjoyment. That was the case with the show Computer Chronicles, which ran from 1981 to 2002. Almost all the episodes from the show's run are available at the Internet Archive at archive.org. If you know what you're looking for, you may find it on other sites like YouTube, Hulu, and many more. While this is all well and good for some, the quality of the video or audio may not be as good. This will usually leave anxious viewers and devoted followers of a certain TV show to wonder a few things. Will they ever re-air these shows on a specific network? Are they available for stream or download somewhere? When will they release this show on DVD? Sites like TVShowsOnDVD.com has you covered for some older shows. If there isn't a high demand for a DVD release, or if certain rights to release it in that format cannot be obtained, you may be out of luck there. Even though some sites offer internet petitions to sign to get your favorite TV show released, there's no guarantee you'll see that show hit store shelves anytime soon. So, what's left? Most people who were able to capture and preserve these episodes on VHS either keep them in a private collection, or they may release them on unofficial bootleg DVDs. Sometimes, some programs get an official DVD release, other shows may not. For example, Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends saw a DVD release in the UK. It seems like it's going to be a while before we get to see an official release of Spidey here in the US. What about other shows that I and probably others grew up watching? Starcade? Video Power? CNET Central? GamePro? The Electric Playground? Remember those? If you know where to look, you can catch either clips or whole episodes on the internet. And while The Electric Playground continues to broadcast both on the web and TV stations, even today, there hasn't been talk of a DVD release or airing of episodes from their humble beginnings in the mid-1990s. Now, you can say that shows like this that feature or talk about outdated technology or talk about something that happened 20-plus years ago would not make profitable DVD releases or be worthy of archiving or airing again on television or a digital format. They do have sites like TelevisionArchive.org that feature news coverage and footage concerning the 9/11 tragedy and is available to users for research or historical purposes. Now, for nostalgic nuts like myself who just want to see those 5 episodes of GamePro TV that I missed as a kid, or those obscure Saturday morning cartoons that we only saw 1 episode of on a compilation DVD, our options are limited. But you know that somewhere out there is a guy who owns original masters or high-quality versions of these shows. They have no intention of releasing it to the public or making any kind of profit off of unofficial screenings in his or her basement. And we don't even know where to find people like that. I know it's some kind of freaky nostalgic dream, not to mention creepy, but we can dream, right? We can dream of one day being able to see all those older TV programs in their entirety, the same way viewers can watch episodes of classic shows like I Love Lucy. Maybe one day that small number of viewers who remember shows that became lost souls after cancellation can relive their childhood for a second time.
Of course, how else would it be for someone who can keep an entire ballet in their head?